Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So as you know that we have started our schedule number 8 and from that 8th schedule today we will discuss the next lesson from the standard 7, that is lesson number 10, disaster management. Okay. So there are the certain disasters, or the disaster means what? There are the certain things which happens and that destroy the living things, or that destroy the all the nature also, we can say. So there are the basically two types of the disasters are there, that are natural disasters and the man-made disasters. Okay, so we have studied the two types of the disaster, namely man-made and the natural disaster. So natural disaster, obviously it will causes due to the nature, and man-made means what? It causes due to the man. Okay, or we can say which are the man-made disaster. We can say some bomb blasts are there, then it is what? Man-made disaster. And the natural disasters are such as famine, lightning strikes, cloud burst, storms, etc. And all these are what? Natural disaster. So this natural disaster and the man-made disasters, both are related to each other. Okay, see, if the disaster is related to the man-made, if the bomb blast is there, but because of that bomb blast, what will happen? The living things will also get disturbed, and with the help of that, the natural things are also get disturbed, the nature is also get disturbed. Okay, so these both the changes are related to each other. There is a possibility of the loss of life and damage to property in such natural disaster. So because of this such natural disaster, what happened? There is a loss of life also, and there is a damage of the property also. Okay, so this is about what? The natural and the man-made disaster. So among these natural disaster, first we will discuss the famine. Okay, now what is mean by famine? So it is a condition that arises due to long term and severe scarcity of food, grain and water is called famine. Okay, so what is mean by the famine? So in during the famine, it is the condition, in that condition there are the long term and the severe scarcity of food, grain and water. So if there is a scarcity of the food, grain and the water for the long period of the time, then that condition, then that phase is called as what? Famine. Famine can also be very severe. Although the main cause of famine is natural phenomena, yet a famine condition is created by some human activities besides some natural events. Okay, so basically we are telling that this famine is a natural disaster, but for that natural disaster also somehow there are the certain human activities are there which are responsible. Okay, so how the human activities are responsible for the famine? We can say that nowadays there is a population increases day by day, so they are using the more amount of the water, but in that same proportion the amount of the water is not going underground, or there is a seepage of the water, the amount of the seepage of the water in ground is less. Okay, but the uses of the water is more, and because of that also we can say there is a famine. So the people are not getting the enough amount of the water for the drinking purpose and for the irrigation purpose also. And also we can say that there is a less amount of the water, so the evaporation is also less, and which causes the less rainfall, and that causes the famine, we can say that. So let's see which are the causes of the famine. Drought, heavy rains and flood, crops getting washed away or damaged in the flood. Environmental changes such as temperature change, storms, cold, waves or fog, damages of crop by animals like mice and rat, attack of pets, lobsters, or diseases of crops, or natural calamities like earthquake, etc. Okay, so exactly there are the so many different causes of the famine. Some are of them what? Drought means what? Very less rainfall, or there is a scarcity of the water, and because of that there is a scarcity of the food grain. Also we can say the heavy rains which washed out all the food, grains or the crops. Next one is what? Environmental changes. Now environmental changes such as what? Temperature change, storms, cloud waves or fog. And because of all these environmental changes which causes the damage of the crops. Also there are the certain animals which also causes the loss to the food grains, animals such as mice and rats, that also we can see the attack of the pest. Because of that, what happened? The more amount of the food grains are getting destroyed. Also the diseases like locusts or the diseases of the crops, and all these are the natural calamity like earthquake. Okay, so during the earthquake also so many food grains are getting disturbed or destroyed, and which causes what? Famine. So all these are the certain reasons because of what happens, famine is happening. What is the famine? The scarcity of the water and the food grain for the long term, it is called as what? Famine. So next one is there, of these, drought is a main cause. Man-made causes of famine includes war, internal unrest, absence of transport routes, uncontrolled population growth. Okay, so among all these things, the drought is a main cause for the famine. Okay, so why the drought is the main cause? Because drought means what? The very less rainfall happens. Because of that, there is a less amount of the water for drinking also and for the irrigation of the crop also. Okay, so next one is what? Which is the man-made cause for the famine? That war, internal unrest, and absence of the transport routes, all these are what? The man-made causes which causes the famine. And also very important, that is what? Uncontrolled population growth. Okay, now the next one we'll see. There are the records of the loss of the life caused by severe famine in various parts of world. Asia has turned out to be the most famine affected continent of the world. Okay, so among the seven continents, Asia is the most famine affected continent of the world. A majority of famine occurred in drought prone and food affected region. Among the most dreadful famines that have occurred in the world are the famines that affected India and China. So among most of the famine which that affects the India and China was very famous. Okay, we can say that it was very dangerous also. So let's see, which are the, are we responsible for our famine, or which are the human activities which are responsible for the famine? Water shortage is increasing as the balance between the rainfall and population is disturbed. Okay, so water shortage is increasing and the balance between the rainfall and population is get disturbed. Okay, so see, before also I have said that the population is increasing day by day, and as we know, the water, food and shelter, these are our basic needs. Okay, but in this situation what happened? The amount of the rainfall is getting decreases. The seepage of the water, underground water, means what? The water going into the underground is less, but the use of the water is more. Okay, and that is also the one more reason for the famine. Though there has been a very high rise in the production of food grains as a result of the green revolution, the balance of the environment has been lost due to the use of the chemical fertilizer, pesticides and the weedicide. See here, again the same reason, we can say the population is increasing day by day. For that increasing population, we have to feed their basic need, that is what? Food. And to take the more and more amount of the food, the farmers are using the different types of the chemical fertilizers. Also to protect the crops from the attack of the pest, they are using the pesticide. Sometimes they are using the weedicides also to protect the crop from the weeds. So in this way, they are using these certain chemicals which are creates the imbalance in the environment. Okay, so on the one hand, with the help of the green revolution, it is useful or it is possible to take the more amount of the production of the food grains. But on the other hand, to take this more amount of the production, the farmers are using the different fertilizer, pesticides and weedicides which is responsible to destroy the balance of the environment. Also, there are the certain reasons we can say that unlimited lifting of water means using more and more amount of the water, erosion of the land and misuse of the water, which is very important. Okay, so we should not waste the water, we should use the water economically. So these are the certain human activities are there which are responsible for the famine. Now we will move for the next point. What can we do to ease the severity of famine. Okay, so what we have to do to decrease the severity of famine? Plan usage of water and reuse of water. Very important point, students. You have to keep in the mind and you should follow it also. That is what? Plan usage of water and reuse the water. Means we have to plan the water that how we will use it. And very important is that we have to reuse the water. Now, reuse the water means what? As we know, there are the different chemical industries which are using the water, but it is polluted water. So we can reuse that water. Before using that, we have to destroy all that chemicals from the water, and then we can use it for the different purposes, not for the drinking purpose, but at least for the sanitary wash, for that purpose in the toilet bathrooms we can use that waters. Okay, next one is the proper planning of water conservation and harvesting at the local levels. Okay, for the water conservation and the harvesting of the water, we have to do the proper planning at least at our local level. Next one, large scale plantation of trees and prevention of deforestation. Very important point, that is what? Large scale plantation. We have to grow more and more crops, and also we have to prevention, we have to stop the deforestation. Deforestation means what? We have to stop the cutting of the trees. Making appropriate changes in plants, taking into account the weather forecast. Okay, so if there are, as we know, the weather forecasting is telling us the information about the changes in the weather, and according to that we have to changes the plan. Okay, or we have to making the appropriate changes in our plan, taking into account the weather forecast. According to that weather forecast, we have to change somehow our plans. Okay, so all these are the things that we can do to decrease the severity of famine. So today we have discussed about the one natural disaster, that is nothing but what? Famine. So here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point from the same lesson. And for today, thank you.